You say it was 100 and what gallons?
It burns about, normally about 120, 25 gallons an hour under normal operations. I'm just climbing at 12,500. It burns about 80 gallons for a round trip.
What's it climb at?
95 knots.
I mean, what's the...
Rate of climb starts out about 1,000 feet a minute, and then up above 10,000, it's about 500 feet a minute.
Is that what you're doing, about 1,000 on the way up there?
Yeah, pretty close to it. Depends on the day and the weather, whether I got two loads of fuel or one.
Uh-huh.
We're going to try and get the guys in Orlando to do it. They have a prop shop in Orlando. Well, it's part of the company in Miami. They're going to send us, hopefully send the right tools up there and parts. Because it's a 3-hour trip from Deland to Miami. So it'd be much smarter to get it done right there in Orlando.
Is that where you went to Miami or Opa-locka?
Yeah, Opa-locka. It's Miami prop shop, but it's in Opa-locka.
Yeah, I think I've seen that place.
Actually, the shop is not there at all.
You don't have to worry about hitting the tail.
I told her it's a lot easier to get out of this thing than the 182.
You just gotta shut your eyes and keep them shut for about 15 seconds, then you can open them.
You bet.
Yeah, but in the meantime, I'll be bumping off everybody.
No. You go by yourself? I'll go with you, Beebs. We'll just take a little two-way off.
You need a hand with it.
Look at me. They strap you to the floor, man.
Mark, I think I got it.
They strap you to the floor. Warpy.
So I guess you can work the door.
Extending my capabilities, putting oil in that reservoir and safety wire and that.
Yeah.
Basically, yeah.
Hey, so that door can work from the front and the back?
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't see many of these things.
Oh, look at the floor.
Off the side in the back there.
Yeah. It comes out of the wall.
Uh-huh.
I mean, from the top above the fastener seat belts on the front.
So you mostly check the oil. You don't check the oil from the engines from here, do you?
Yeah.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, the filler and the dipstick is right here at the wing, just outside the nacelle. It's got a 22-gallon tank on each side.
God, seems like it'd be more. Oil. Is
they
that?
They use about a gallon of oil an hour.
Was that about the same amount of fuel that you carried?
The fuel total fuel capacity is 825 gallons.
Uh-oh.
You tucked it off.
So where's the rest of it? All in the
wing, yeah. 414 gallons. It's 428. It's 414 on each side.
So where'd you fill up?
There's one filler tank on each side. Is this red square out here? It was really built to be an airliner to have considerable more range. And some trees with an extended range fuel tanks will go something like 1,500 miles. Twice as much as it. Of course, they're burning less gas, too.
13 seconds or something.
All right, James. What? Here are the winning lotto numbers.
922.
We got two of them.
Yeah, that'd have been nice, wouldn't it?
What was it, 28? 4. 21, 25, 30, 35, 4. Well, that's getting close.
Did this thing have any guns?
No, it
on the cache 3 and on the plate 4, it was all 922s.
We used to have kerchiefs that would shoot machine guns off the back here.
Just for fun.
Hand grenades and mortar rounds off the ramp.
Just
and
for
I
fun.
I used to have a co-pilot that loved to shoot a Thompson submachine gun out the right window.
I don't know, it'll be women soon, I think.
But it really wasn't meant to be a gunship. It was strictly to haul freight and people.
There's a co-pilot hard at work here.
Yeah. It's a tough job.
She just found out she lost the lottery. She lost the lottery again, so she's happy.
I'm scared of heights, that's why you don't
do it. Do y'all jump?
No. She did in the Army.
Heavens no.
Heavens.
Yeah, but you don't know what's going to happen unless you try it. She is still working on the this 19th. Yes way. Yes way, you're going. Thank you.
These are tight.
You thought that? Mess me up.
They're far as hell away. See them over there? Look, they're still going.